counting, but go with it, girl. Yeah, just close your eyes. Yeah, I feel the music moving through your body. Looking at you, I can tell you want it. Don't stop, keep going till the morning light. Yeah, when I saw you there, sitting all alone in the dark, acting like you didn't have to care. I knew right then that you'd be mine, and we'd be dancing the whole damn night. Like, ooh, ooh, oh, baby, and I just want you to dance with me tonight. So come on, ooh, ooh, oh, baby, I just want you. One more time, come on now. Just don't get it. Do you enjoy being hurt? I know you smell the perfume, the makeup on his shirt. You don't believe his stories. You know that there are lies. Bad as you are, you stick around, and I just don't know why.
If I was your man,
baby, you
never worry about
what I do.
I'd be coming home
back to you every night, doing you right.
Type of woman,
deserve good fame,
fist full of diamonds,
a head full of rain,
maybe you're a star.
I just wanna show you you are, you should let me love you, let me be the one to give you everything you want and need. Baby, good love and protection, make me your selection, show you the way love's supposed to be. Baby, you should let me love you, love you, love you, love you, yeah. Listen, your true beauty's description looks so good that it hurts. You're a dime plus 99 and it's a shame, don't even know what you're worth. Everywhere you go, they stop and stare, cause you're better than chose. From your head to your toes, out of control. Baby, you know,
if I was your man,
baby, you
never worry about
what I do.
I be coming home
back to you every night, doing you right.
You're the type of woman,
deserves good things,
fist full of diamonds,
a head full of rings.
Baby, you're a star.
I just wanna show you you are. You should let me love you. Let me be the one to give you everything you want and need. Oh, baby, good love and protection. Oh, make me your selection. Show you the way love's supposed to be. Baby, you should let me.
You deserve better.
You know you deserve better.
We should be together.
Baby,
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Dunbar High School Class of 2023 Senior Commencement Ceremony. The ceremony will begin with the processional of our platform guests, participants, and special guests, followed by the graduates. Ladies and gentlemen, graduation ceremonies are formal events that require proper etiquette and decorum. I would like to review a few. Please silence your phones during the ceremony to avoid any distractions and disruptions. Guests should remain in their seats during the ceremony, except when directed to stand for the Black National Anthem, the alma mater, and the conferring of diplomas. It is important to celebrate the graduates' accomplishments respectfully during the ceremony. This includes cheering and clapping, but not disrupting the ceremony to the point where it distracts from the experiences of others. Graduates and guests should also avoid throwing anything such as caps and confetti. And this ceremony is, again, as mentioned, a formal event, and any noise or disturbances can distract from the experiences for everyone in attendance. Again, please find your seats. We will begin the program in just 2 minutes.
Thank you.
ladies and gentlemen, we will have the presentation of colors, then the singing of the Black National Anthem. Please remain standing. Oh. Please remain standing for the singing of the Black National Anthem. For your convenience, the lyrics are provided in the back of the program. Ladies and gentlemen, and the audience, the class of 2020 and 2023, please be seated. At this time, I would like to introduce to you your Mistress of Ceremonies and the class of 2023, your senior sponsor, Miss Nakisha Yates.
Ooh, I'm on this mic. Good evening, class of 2023. How y'all doing? If you don't know me, I am Miss Yates, known to many as Miss Lit, because I am lit for all things. And on tonight, I am absolutely lit for class of 2023. Y'all already know it's y'all for me. So it has been a pleasure and an honor to serve as your senior class sponsor this year and to serve as your English teacher to many of you. Shout out to English, absolutely. So tonight, I would like to have the honor and privilege to introduce our amazing stage guests. Stage guests, please stand and wave as you are introduced. This evening, we have Instructional Superintendent Dr. Kimberly Martin. Dunbar High School Principal, Ms. Nadine Smith. Dunbar Alumni Federation President, Ms. Rosa Singletary. Our commencement speaker this evening, Mr. LeGreg Harrison, CEO of the Museum Clothing Company. Our acting 12th grade assistant principal, McCurry Pugh. Assistant Principal Tiffany White, Valedictorian Ariana Guerrero, next to our valedictorian, we do have an empty seat because on tonight we will remember and recognize our senior who is not with us tonight but should be. We have a seat here and a diploma here for Seth Emmanuel Christie. Our salutatorian, Miss Serene Cece Aridi. We have our student performer tonight, Iman Bangura. And then we have a king representing the Black Studies Academy who will introduce our commencement speaker, King Qaddus Zurihun. Thank you so much, esteemed platform guest. And now we will hear from acting 12th grade assistant principal, AP Pugh.
How y'all doing this evening? At Dunbar, we have the privilege of working alongside these bright young minds, witnessing their growth and development over the years. Today, we honor those who have exceeded our expectations with their unwavering commitment to excellence. Without further ado, I would like to introduce some of the high-achieving students of the class of 2023 and present them with the awards they have earned through their exceptional academic performance and outstanding character. Students, when you hear your name, please stand up to be recognized. We're gonna start with the valedictorian, given to the student with the overall highest GPA, Ariana Guerrero. For our salutatorian, the student with the second highest GPA, Cece Aridi Serene. The Leadership Award, given to a student who demonstrates leadership skills amongst their peers, Serene Cece Aridi. The Citizenship Award, given to a student who demonstrates school spirit and pride to the fullest, Laura Chicas. The Principal's Achievement celebrates outstanding achievement by dedicated students in the realm of academics and other contributions to the school, Qaddus Zurihun. The CTE Award, given to a student who demonstrates significant achievements in career and technical education, Naziah Lashley. The Student Athlete Award, given to a student who demonstrates significant achievement in the area of athletics, Zaniah Gavins. This next award is very special. It is the Inspirational Educator Award. This is voted on by you all, the students. And we actually have two people receiving this award today, Ms. Sanjay Young Joyner and Mr. Brewer. We're incredibly proud of these students and their dedication to making a difference. Class of 2023, you have truly embodied the spirit of excellence, and we are confident that you will continue to achieve great things in the next chapter of your lives. Thank you, and once again, congratulations to the class of 2023. Ladies and gentlemen, it is now my pleasure to welcome and introduce to the podium our 2023 salutatorian, Ms. Serene Cece Aridi, who will be attending the University of Maryland at College Park this fall.
Good evening, everybody. My name is Serene Aridi, but my classmates know me as Cece. It is my honor to stand here before you all as salutatorian of class of 2023. Before I begin, let's give a round of applause for our esteemed teachers, staff, faculty, and most importantly, the village. But most importantly, I would love to thank my sister, my older sister, my sister mom, guardian, Maya Aridi. She's in the crowd in section 104. Without her, I would not be on this stage right now. She is my inspiration. She is who I strive to be every day. She has taught me kindness, selflessness, and she has taught me how to be pleasantly annoying with my academics. My teachers know this. But let's get started. It is not about how you start, but how you finish. I believe this quote near perfectly describes the class of 2023 experience. How do we start our freshman year? It was cut short with the rise of COVID-19, the tempting desire to sleep through every Zoom meeting and actually sleeping through them. Having to write countless assignments where we found ourselves using Google way more than we should have. All in all, we've had an unconventional start to our high school journey, but it is how we finish that determines our character. Fellow graduates, today you have finished your high school journey, but remember to always persevere in every aspect of your life. Whether you are going to college, trade school, the workforce, the military, or even taking a gap year, be resilient. Don't let anyone hold you back from being the greatest version of yourself. And remember to always finish strong. Thank you.
Thank you so much, salutatorian. Give it up one more time for your class salutatorian, Cece Aridi. The heartbeat of Dunbar. This queen is gonna go far. Ooh. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we will hear from our class of 2023 valedictorian. This young queen has worked extremely hard and she was absolutely determined to work her way to the top. The epitome of a young black queen, Ariana L.A. Guerrero, will be attending Stanford University in the fall.
Good evening, everyone. How are we feeling tonight? Firstly, I would like to say how excited and honored I am to be here speaking in front of my peers on our big graduation day. As you know, I am Ariana Guerrero, and not only am I your 2023 valedictorian, I am your proud senior class president, as well as the captain of the track and field team. Before we get started, I would like to share a special shout out to the track and field team. Not only are Cece and I student athletes, we are both track and field athletes. And to have two track and field athletes be valedictorian and salutatorian is a huge deal and honor, so give it up for us. My mother always quotes the author Miguel Ruiz. She says he talks about resistance, that resistance can come from inside your own head, like your doubts and second guessing yourself, or that resistance can come from outside of you, such as people telling you that you are not good enough or that you don't belong. That being said, the class of 2023 has gone through so much resistance. Some of us have passed away, including my teammate, Seth Christie. Many of us also lost loved ones. Resistance also showed up as COVID-19. We all know our freshman year was cut short due to COVID-19. And our sophomore year was completely virtual and everyone had to adapt to a new way of learning. It was not until our junior year that we had our first full year of in-person learning. One thing I learned over these 4 years is that not everything goes according to plan, and further, resistance will always show up to try to deter you from your planned course. Personally, resistance has shown up all throughout my 4 years of high school. I thought I had everything figured out, but the resistance had other plans. My freshman year, I switched schools 2 weeks before we went on quarantine. I've only gotten into 3 of the universities I applied to. My mom has been unemployed for over a year, which has placed a financial burden on my household. I've had outside resistance, such as people telling me that I'm whitewashed or that I'm not really Latina, porque yo no hablo español fluencia, pero yo soy afro-latina, yo soy boricueña, yo soy dominicana. I could go on and on about the times that resistance has showed up. In the midst of all the resistance, ultimately, I've had some truly amazing highlights of my senior career. I was inducted into the National Honor Society my junior year. I broke the long jump record at our state meet. I completed our Drew Engineering Academy. I decided to continue my education at Stanford University. And now I can say I finished top of my class. I share all of this to say, despite the resistance our community was up against, we are still here and thriving, finishing off our senior year. We have a class, have a multitude of scholars heading to college or trade school on a full ride, and we as a class have been instrumental to helping our school's new redesign. Our basketball team and girls track team brought home city championships this year. We made it. And no matter how we may feel about certain times and experiences at Dunbar, we can always say proudly that we went to the Paul Historic Dunbar. The first public high school for Black students. We have a foundation. Daily, we are surrounded by Black and Brown excellence. I personally think this should be our motivator here moving forward. As adults who came up in DC, we constantly deal with the resistance of loss, violence, and frankly, people not believing in us. Today, we showed all our haters, we pushed through, we prevailed, and we are proud. We should all be proud of this moment, as it is not a moment to take lightly. Before I step away from the podium, I would like to give a few thank yous out. I would like to thank Mr. Toddy, Ms. Yates, Ms. O'Neill, Mr. Allard, Coach Clark, Mr. Diallo, Mrs. Mitchell, Mr. Jackson, and AP Lawrence for making my years at Dunbar meaningful. Thank you, Coach Marvin Parker, for always believing in me and sticking by me throughout my years at Dunbar. Thank you to my wonderful family for always showing up when it counts. Thank you to my father for being supportive. And lastly, I would like to thank my amazing mother for being with me every step of the way, whether that be with school, track and field, or anything I could possibly need her for. My mom is the one person I know I can count on. And I will always love and appreciate her for being the best mother and support system I can ask for. So thank you. Class of 2023, as we continue on with our lives, I want you to always push through the resistance and rise above. Congratulations, class of 2023.
Give it up one more time for your valedictorian. We can't wait to see you go forth to Stanford University and be great. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to keep the show going. And now it is my pleasure to introduce this king. Whew. And now to introduce our amazing, dope, powerful commencement speaker. This king is representing the Black Studies Academy, his peers, the youth, and the community, in addition to attending the George Washington University on a full ride. Being one of our 2 students who received the Trachtenberg Scholarship, Qudus Zurihun.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, esteemed faculty members, honored guests, and most of all, class of 2023. My name is Qudus Zurihun, and I am honored today to introduce our commencement speaker this evening, who is Mr. LeGreg Harrison. But before we start, let me give you a little background, little bio to for his credit. LeGreg, known affectionately as G, is an American marketing executive expert, most known for his professional contribution during his tenure at Apple Bottoms, Live Mechanics, Nuvo, and as the co-founder and chief executive officer of the board administration alongside Warner Bros. Records recording artist, DC native, Wal Follerin. His latest business ventures include the Museum DC Fashion and Art Gallery, Legacy Established Recording Label, Future Modules Enterprise, and Future Modules Inc. Recently, LeGreg Harrison was honored as top 40 under 40 in the Washington Business Journal and one of 100 Black Enterprises Be Modern Men of 2016. Among other accomplishments, he is currently the artiste in residence partner with Washington Commander NFL team. In partnership with the Emerson Collective, he is the interim retail village lifestyle manager located on the St. Elizabeth campus in Southeast Washington, D.C. He was also featured as one of the top industry lifestylists for Washington, D.C. in the Complex magazine series documentary called Run the Underground. LeGreg Harrison is currently running his D.C.-based nonprofit organization, Our Future Modules. LeGreg Harrison has consulted for brands such as Under Armour, Curry Brand, Adidas, Fila, Foot Locker, Warner Bros. Records, and several professional athletes. So now, please help me applaud by applauding and help us welcome LeGreg Harrison to the mic.
Let me get another round of applause, please. Thank you. Hey, listen, before I start, y'all are beautiful. This is amazing, Dunbar, seriously. Because I've done a couple of commencements, man, and the support that y'all getting right now is crazy. Make sure y'all give y'all parents and family a round of applause right now. This is incredible. This is truly incredible. Good evening. Ladies and gentlemen, esteemed faculty, proud parents, and most importantly, the brilliant graduating class of Dunbar's Crimson Tide. It is an absolute honor to stand before you today as we celebrate this momentous occasion. This is your night, but I encourage you to share it with the people who helped you to get here to this milestone. Your parents, your family, and these teachers and professors at your school. I'm not an architect of words or a poet like Michelangelo or a diamond selling recording artist like NBA Youngboy. I'm definitely not a 6'8 NBA star, NBA champion like LeBron James, but I'm here to inspire you, empower you, and hopefully ignite the flames of your dreams. I want to take you on a journey of transformation, a journey of growth, and the pursuit of becoming the best version of yourselves. Today is the rest of your life. Not the ending of your yesterday, but the beginning of your tomorrow. That's today. Why is today the rest of your life? Because there are no guarantees for tomorrow and no revisiting yesterday. Again, there's nothing you can do about yesterday. You don't know what's going to happen tomorrow, but you can prepare yourselves for the unknown. There's no light without dark. There's no good without evil. There's no wins without losses. There's no reward without risk. Life without death and success with some type of sacrifice. One thing that I can guarantee is that life is going to take you for a ride, and most of the time it offers only one seat in the vehicle, and you can only take yourself with you. You'll hit some speed bumps and potholes, worse than the ones in your neighborhood, northeast and uptown streets. Life will come at you fast, and you'll be forced to speed up. Or maybe you'll be slowed down by the naysayers in a doubter traffic that's worse than rush hour traffic on 395. The reason why I say naysayer and doubter traffic is because it's always crowded there. It's crowded where the losers play, but not this group right here at Dunbar High. These past 4 years, you've been through the ups and downs, all the mental and physical battles that you had to endure, the late night studying of exams, constantly being challenged to be the best version of yourselves, and it's gotten you to this point of celebration. This is a major, major, major accomplishment. I want you to feel special today. Today, you've separated yourselves from mediocrity. You are not an option today. You are the rule. You are the exception. You took the road less traveled by, and I respect it. It's honorable in that alone. See, everybody can't win. Everyone won't win. To be a winner, you have to be consistently going beyond your best. You have to push when no one else will. You have to work when no one else is watching or telling you to do so. You have to be willing to make sacrifices that no one else will. I challenge you today, Dunbar, graduating class of 2023, to go beyond your best. I'll tell you this. Your dreams are not enough on their own. They require action, perseverance, and an unwavering commitment to growth. Embrace the challenges, for they are stepping stones to success. Embrace failure, for it is the greatest teacher that will guide you towards your true path. Embrace setbacks, for they will fuel your determination to rise even higher. Remember, success is not measured solely by the destination, but by the purposeful journey you undertake to reach it. Life is not a sprint, it's a marathon. Enjoy every step of your journey, relish in the moments of triumph, and learn from the moments of defeat. Each experience molds you, it strengthens you, and prepares you for your next chapter. Do me this last favor. Don't go off saying you graduated today. Say I'm graduating, because to ED means to end, but to ING means a continuation. Never stop graduating to the next level. Never become satisfied. Define your role and take hold and control of what's yours. Go get what God has for you. Compete for it. There should be a tug of war in your body every day between your heart, what your heart feels, and what your mind tells you to do. I want you to follow your heart, not your mind. The mind is going to say, will I, won't I, should I, shouldn't I, can I, couldn't I? But we're not asking for permission over here. We're just going to follow our heart, and we'll ask for forgiveness later. Thank you. Before I leave, I want to leave you with this one thing. This is from my dad, who was also an actor, an author, Fahim Abdul Salam. As you go on to your journey, take this with you. It's helped me through 30 years of my life. Never delegate the responsibility of loving you to someone else. If you do, they may stop loving you without your permission. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Mr. LeGreg Harrison. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up for our commencement speaker one more time. Thank you for coming out and pouring into our youth and all that you do for our community. Thank you for being the epitome of a Black king. All right, so y'all getting excited? Because we're getting closer and closer to the moment that y'all are waiting for. All right, so. Ladies and gentlemen, it is now my honor and a pleasure. Please join me in welcoming to the stage our fearless, revolutionary, powerful, visionary leader of our school, the mother of Dunbar, our Yeye, your principal, the principal of Dunbar High School, the first public Black high school, Miss Nadine Smith.
No, I'm good. Good night, everybody. Good evening. Can I hear y'all, class of 2023? Celebrate yourselves. All right, before I get into it, I have a message here from AP English. She's been texting me, and she wanted me to read this to you. She said, as many of you know, she's home recovering. She said, to the class of 2023, I'm devastated I could not be here in person, but please, I need you to know I am there in spirit with each and every one of you. I'm proud of each of you, and when I think of this class, my heart will always smile. I will come back to visit me, please. Stay up. And what else did she say? She said, love you all, AP English. So clap it up for AP English. Yes, ma'am. All right, so class of 2023, we are here. It's been a journey. Hold on a second.
Yes, take it, I can't do it.
It's been a journey, the way this thing started. But I love what someone said earlier. It's not how we start, it's how we end it. All right. Good evening, Dunbar parents, faculty, families, and our esteemed guests, and most importantly, class of 2023. 23, during this message, I need y'all to talk back to me. I need y'all to clap it up. Y'all already know what it is. Today, we are here to honor you and to celebrate you as you begin your new journey. Before we get into that, I'd like to acknowledge the village, all these people that showed up for you. The mothers, the fathers, the uncles, the cousins, the tias, the pop-pops, the guardians. Please clap it up. Parents, we know that you send us your best. Thank you for trusting us with your kids for 4 years. Your love, your strength, and determination is why they are here today. Graduates, get on your feet, stand up, clap it up for your village behind you. Come on, y'all. Look at that village. You may be seated. Thank you. I would also like to recognize the other members of the village, the incredible faculty and staff of Dunbar High School. Stand up, please, who have poured into our kids every single day. Dunbar faculty and staff, stand up. Thank you. Special thank you to that 12th grade team on the fourth floor, the penthouse, the dream team. Thank you for your work this year. Thank you for working tirelessly to get 23 to the finish line. Thank you to AP English, again, and the dream team for all that you do. Special thank you to our Alumni Federation. I'd like to recognize Ms. Carrie Thornhill and Ms. Rosa Singletary, Chair and Vice Chair of the Dunbar Alumni Federation, for their continued support. This year alone, our federation gave out over $50,000 in scholarships to our students. In addition to our alumni base, I'd like to acknowledge the many, many, many community members and our incredible athletic coaches that have supported Dunbar throughout the years. These individuals continuously go above and beyond for the students of Dunbar High School. So thank you. Again, clap it up for the village. All right, class of 2023, you are truly an exceptional group of young people. So many valuable lessons have been learned from this class, but what you may not know, as much as you learned from us, you have been our greatest teachers. We have laughed with you, we've cried, we've learned from one another, we've had to face COVID together, we've celebrated so many successes. This is the class that has helped us to reimagine high school. This is the class that has declared themselves Afrofuturistic. So therefore, this class has earned $8.5 million in scholarship. Let's celebrate that, y'all. 23, it has been a beautiful thing to see you grow and develop over the last few years into the young people that sit in front of me. This evening, before you go, I do want to offer a final Dunbar lesson. Little hacks, little tricks to take you through the next few years. I see a couple of you have your phones in your hand. You could go ahead and take some notes. Y'all ready? All right. Lesson one, life hack number one, believe in yourself. The great writer James Baldwin once said, if the world does it to you long enough and effectively enough, you begin to do it to yourself. You become a collaborator, an accomplice with your murderers. This quote speaks to the idea that if we internalize all the negative talk around us from society, we will start to believe them ourselves. It can't hold you back. You have the power to shape your destiny, each and every one of you that sit in here. Please remember, there is power in the tongue. Speak positively over yourself. Speak positively over your loved one. Hype yourself up. Hype yourself up in the morning and believe in yourself. Lesson one. Lesson two, this is my favorite lesson. Let the haters inspire you. Let me try it again. Lesson two, let the haters inspire you. As you forge your path, there will inevitably be naysayers, there will be critics, right? In the words of Aubrey Drake Graham, one of our philosophers and musicians, jealousy is just love and hate at the very same time. Drake said it so eloquently. The haters want to be you, so don't let it deter you from your path. This reminds us that people's negativity stems from their admiration of you. As Drake would say, let the haters inspire you. You got that? One and two? All right. Lesson number three, you belong here. Lesson number three, you belong here, you deserve to be here. You have a space in this world, you have a space in this city. As I'm driving around DC, I'm seeing all the cranes, I'm seeing the buildings go up, I'm seeing the new neighborhoods, what are they calling it, Sonia, Noma, all this new stuff that's going on in DC. Don't let them push you out, this is your city. Stand your ground and assert your place, for you have earned it through your perseverance, your talents, and your unique perspective. You belong here. Now, about being here, while you're here, strive to live a life of luxury. Yes, I did say that, luxury, and service. I want you to travel to faraway land. I want you to see some world. Work hard to enjoy the finer things in life, but remember, give back. Always give back. Pull up the person next to you. Again, you belong here. Lesson four, we're almost done. Y'all taking notes, right? Yes? Kinda. Lesson four, if it hurts, say ouch. Lesson four, if it hurts, say ouch. When you face hardship, remember, it's okay to say ouch. Acknowledge your struggles, acknowledge your pain. It is not a sign of weakness, but rather a testament to your strength, to your resiliency, and your will to persevere. Ask for the help. Ask for the support. It's okay to take care of yourself spiritually, emotionally, physically, all the things. Take care of you. And again, if it hurts, say, ouch. All right, and the final lesson, your final Dunbar lesson, lesson number five. Family and friends matter. All those people behind you, take a look at them, turn around. They matter. Now, good family and good friends matter. Surround yourself with those who affirm you. Surround yourself with those who support you. Surround yourself with people who cheer for you, right? As you step into your next chapter, right, remember, family and good friends matter. Don't forget where you come from. And I just had to get this in here. And remember, Black lives and brown lives still matter. You matter. Now, if you could keep these five little hacks close by in your back pocket, in your purse, somewhere, it'll get you through. 23, I want to thank you for allowing me to be your principal over the last 4 years. It has been my greatest honor and pleasure. We're proud of you. You will always have a home on N Street. On behalf of the entire faculty and staff and administration of Dunbar High School, I extend our warmest congratulations to you all, and we can't wait to see what you do with everything you've learned at Dunbar. Crimson Tide forever, Roll Tide 23. All right. All right, so now, this is the part. Dr. I.S. Martin, can you join me at the podium? All right. All right, so here it is. We're about to certify this class. And now, by the power vested in me by the mayor of the District of Columbia, Muriel Bowser, and by the chancellor of the District of Columbia Public School, Louis Farabee, I hereby certify the 127 members of the class of 2023 have completed the requirements for graduation from Paul Lawrence Dunbar High School.
On behalf of Mayor Bowser and Chancellor Farabee, I enthusiastically accept the class of 2023 from Paul Lawrence Dunbar High School. Congratulations.
All right, class of 2023, before you stand up to start to do the thing, get the diplomas, I do want to take a moment, if everybody could stay with me. We're going to take a moment of silence. I just need you to stay with me.
So class of 2023. As we prepare for the awarding of diplomas and to celebrate this momentous occasion, let us take a moment to celebrate the life of the beautiful Seth Emmanuel Christie, a 17-year-old outstanding athlete, amazing young king who should be here with us tonight. We celebrate his beautiful life and all that he brought to his family, his friends, his loved ones, and to the Dunbar community. We salute you, King Seth. Tonight, we celebrate Seth Christie and all the young people that we've lost across the city and that should be with us tonight or graduating this year for class of 2023. Ladies and gentlemen, let us now take a moment of silence. Thank you. King Seth, we salute you.
All right, 23, please stand and follow the directions of the ushers down to the stage area. Please stand.
All right, class of 2023. And so first, I want to present the posthumous diploma to King Seth Christie. Ariana L.A. Guerrero. Serene Cece Aridi. Iman Bangura. Kaduz Zurihan. Aldrich Simon. Lara Chicas. Ayana Nickens. Samia Dorsey. Lindsay Cook. Destiny Matt. Samia Douglas. Zaniya Gavins. Rashad Levitt Jr. Tamaya Blair. Danahi McNeil. Amira Henson Green. Josh Finner. Amaria Eaton. Kenyatta Carmichael. Persia Carter. Ricardo Douglas. Zaniya Gavin. I know, that's why I was trying to give me this. Tasia Galloway. Bianna Spinks. Kevin Blanchard. Mackenzie Adams. Kalante Anir Banks. Anissa Hassan. Giovanni Cooper. Kamaya Bridget. Tashawn Nitro Bats. Terrell Abbott. Rakaya Bowie.
Olson Parker. Marche Wilkins. Kayvon Graves. Donye Lucas. Tevante McCullers. Daria Cole. Blake Matthews. Dayana Gore. Damon Mallory. Jayana Chase. Julio Gaskin. Genesis Washington. Cedric Smith. Asia Vi Deshay. Reginald Clemens.
Yeah, yeah, please help.
Tayana Wyatt. Delonte Wyatt. Ayana Briscoe. Layla Wilkins. Daryl Knight. Victoria Hawkins. Shardasia Fry. Hyson Miles. Javon Avins. Ryan Rhodes Wright. Jermaine Chambers. Karan McBride. Jaden Faulkner.
Lydia Enrique. Lydia Enriquez.
Taquan Fields. Tyreek Marshall. You think?
Destiny Wallace. Noah Powell. Destiny Grant. Antonio Bowler. Deanna Williams. Jaden Robinson. Naima Richardson. Shaquan Weaver. Ayana Jones. Andre Green. Aaron Williams. Tremont McCoy. Anaya Simmons. Deshaun Gordon. Jamia Williams. Malachi Moore. Isatu Jakini. Jabril Scott. Uriel Diocho. Elijah Farmer. Emily Fuentes. Richard Brown. Nazaya Lashley. Jabari Brown. Jamaya Newman. Elijah Dorsey Gwynn. Jabria Daniel. Khalil Malik Teray. Micaiah Sheffield. Janaya Medley Johnson. Anaya Alexis Hagens. Brianna Greenlee. Edward Harrison. Mateo Burns. Shajay Bates. Marcel Cradle.
No, you found this one.
Brianna Tucker. Angel Whiting. Brian Perez. Chanel Winslow. Elino Vance. Imani Chase. Daniel Hines. Daynetta Ned.
I'm missing Miss Hicks. I'm actually gonna miss you.
Braxton Collins. Janae Faust. DeMarcus Lockridge. Kanaya Cassell. Keith Williams. Amari Mercer. Jaquan Waller. Aaliyah Johnson. Larry Pickett. Danasia Green. Malcolm Jeter. Kyla Smith. Desiree Hale. Michelle Neely. Samira Giles. Anaya Louder. Santia Porter. Danyana Martin. Yeah,
Rakaya Willis. Kamani McCray. Nakai Bolden. Kayla Frazier. Congratulations again, class of 2020-23. Now, remember when I was telling you to make sure you stay with people who hype you up? Dunbar, go. We doing what? Hype them up. All right. Right now, I'd like to welcome Miss Rosa Singletary to the stage. Ms. Singletary is the Vice Chair of the Dunbar Alumni Federation, the mighty class of 1993. Ms. Singletary will be conducting our Dunbar Alumni Oath.
Good evening, class of 2023. You survived a pandemic, persevered high school, and succeeded. This next chapter will be fun, exciting, scary, all at the same time, but you're more than ready and able. Repeat after me. I do solemnly affirm, as a graduate of Paul Lawrence Dunbar Senior High School, to give without reservation, mental and financial support, to promote the educational and social growth of my alma mater. Thank you, congratulations. We will now hear from our very own Iman Bangura from class of 2023 to sing our beloved Dunbar alma mater. Please find the alma mater in the back of your program.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Miss Iman Bangura. And now, as we prepare to close out, we will hear from our amazing leader, Miss Nadine Smith.
All right, guys, it is that time. You all ready? We're almost at the end. Graduates, this is it. Go forward and be the person that you wish to be. Be bold, courageous, passionate. With you go our fondest memories. Seniors, before the seniors stand, we're gonna ask that the audience, our loved ones, the families, please remain seated. Seniors, please stand. All right. All right, class of 2023, please move your tassel from right to left. It gives me great pleasure to officially welcome you to the family of alumni of our nation's first Black high school, Paul Lawrence Dunbar. Congratulations, class of 2023, you did it. Please stand up and follow the directions. Parents and families, please remain seated as our graduates process out of the auditorium. Again, please remain seated.